Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, April 28th, 2009. The theme hasn't changed this morning. We're still seeing resistance hold us back, and we're still waiting for triggers to tell us that the market is heading lower. On the S&P 500, we're looking for a daily close below 830 on Tuesday to give us a new daily sell signal. The market thermometer indicator is currently sitting at 9. We're looking for it to come down below 7 to indicate that a new trend has started. For the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for a daily close below 1320 on Tuesday. And the market thermometer indicator is currently at 10, indicating that NASDAQ is certainly stronger than the S&P 500 right now. And again, we're waiting for it to come down through 7 to indicate that a new trend has started to take place. Looking at the bank index, we're waiting for a daily close below 90. For the SOX index, we're waiting for a daily close below 242. Talked about gold yesterday, had no confidence in this going higher. It's gold stocks reversed yesterday lower. In the pre-market this morning, gold's down below 900 once again, so we should see some additional selling in the gold stocks on Tuesday. The pros, looking at the XAU, started to come back, but did not get anywhere near taking control. Looking at resistance and support, you can see that we came up to 125, got stuck. My only argument about not going long, the fact that the pros didn't look like they were going to take control, was the fact that the most I could see is going was up to 137.50, which for some people could be very interesting. For me, given the other opportunities we're waiting for, I didn't think it was that big a deal to tie up money in the gold sector right now. Looking at the ultra shorts, oil and gas, here's one that we've been whipsawed in the past week, looking for a daily close above 24. The market thermometer indicator is down at 2. We've had a couple of instances where it's been up as high as 4, and we still couldn't get a trend started. So I'm going to sit back and wait till it gets above 5 before I initiate any short position in the oil and gas sector using the ultra short ETF. Looking at the ultra shorts for the Dow, we're looking for a daily close above 57.50. That market thermometer indicator for that particular ETF is currently sitting at 1. Again, above 3 should tell us that a new uptrend for this particular ETF has started. Looking at the ultra shorts for the Qs, we need a daily close above 42. And for all these ETFs, we're going to be watching the smart money to see if the pros come back and take control. Currently, for the just like as the NASDAQ is sitting at 10, the ultra shorts for the Qs are sitting at 0 on the market thermometer indicator. Again, we're going to need to see the market thermometer indicator come up above 3 before we're going to see a new uptrend for this particular ETF start. Looking at the ultras for the financial sector, we need a daily close above 70 on Tuesday to give us a new daily buy signal. Market thermometer indicator is currently at 0. Again, we're going to be waiting for it to come up above 3 to indicate that a new trend to the upside has started. One commodity that a lot of people are watching is copper. Copper has broken down in the last week, currently on a sell signal, and we need a daily close above 280 to give us a new buy signal right now. The market thermometer indicator is confirming that downtrend. We're certainly looking for the flypaper channel to act as support, and the flypaper channel is just below where we are right now, so hopefully that will act as support, and copper will be able to find some footing and turn around in the next week or so. Looking at some of the stocks I'm following closely, Apple Computer up at need a daily close below 120 on Tuesday to give us a new sell signal. Market thermometer indicator is currently at 10. Looking at General Electric, we need a daily close on Tuesday below 11:20. Market thermometer indicator is currently at 9. Looking at IBM, a little weak yesterday. We need a daily close below 99. Market thermometer has started to fall and is currently sitting at 7. So a breakdown below here would confirm a new downtrend for IBM and would be the first of the stocks we're following closely to give a sell signal. Looking at RIM, still up at the top there. We need a daily close below 64.90 right now to give us a new sell signal. The pros are still certainly in control of this stock and not looking for it to break down on Tuesday. Market thermometer indicator is at 10 and certainly indicating that this stock is motoring right along. Looking at the VIX, looking at daily charts for the VIX, we need a daily close above 38.50 to give us a new buy signal right now. Still watching the pros, have not taken control yet. The market thermometer indicator has started to move up. The indicator above, which is the percentage of up days, is down at the lows where it was in late December. And at that point, the VIX started to move higher. And so we would expect something similar to take place right now. A higher VIX means lower stock prices. Currently, the market thermometer indicator is at 4 and moving higher, and that would tell us that we're going to see upward pressure on the VIX. Looking at the futures in the pre-market on Tuesday, we've got them down across the board, similar to what we had yesterday. And remember, yesterday we had a weak open and then certainly came back during the day. Both crude oil and gold are down in the pre-market on Tuesday. We need to see the market start trading below 840 before we can say that the bears are back in control. Looking at the 60-minute charts, we need an hourly close above 865 on Tuesday to give us a new intraday buy signal for the S&P 500. The NASDAQ, a bit stronger. We need to see closes below 1300 to tell us that the bears are back in control. To get a sell signal on Tuesday, we need an hourly close below 1366 on the NASDAQ 100. And last but not least this morning, a 60-minute chart for the VIX, currently above the flypaper channel, but haven't been able to move away from it yet. We'll probably get to do that on Tuesday. To see if the uptrend in the VIX is over, we would need to see a close below 37.90. If the uptrend in the VIX ends, that would probably indicate that the downtrend in the stock market is also over, and we would look for higher stock prices on Tuesday. Don't think we're going to see that at the open. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.